Welcome back to Your Property Empire. We're now joined by Jane Ferguson from Century 21, who's going to give us the latest property numbers. Now, Charles Tarby's normally on the show. He takes more holidays than me and is missing in action. What's he up to?
That's right. He's actually in Newcastle this weekend. He's at one of our brand new office openings, which is really exciting. Our brand's opened, I think it's 8 offices this quarter, so things are looking really good for us.
So he's expanding so fast, we can't get him on the news
and
anymore.
And he's good. He's at all of them and,
at least he understands what's going on around Australia.
Exactly, that's right.
So while we're talking about that, what's happened to the clearance rates in the last week?
Yeah, so the national average this week is in fact down. It's at 68.9% in comparison to the same time last year. But these are some steady rates and we're looking for some good room for growth. So Sydney is 76.7%, Melbourne at 69%, and Adelaide, which is the one you guys have been talking about for a long time now, is still performing really well at 61%.
And so this is good because we're pretty much right in the middle of winter. Even Tom was talking about, yeah, it's so cold, people aren't getting out in the streets, but there's still reasonable activity out there, which is great.
That's right, yes.
Good stuff. So now we get on to homes advertised for sale. Is there any hope for people out there to get some new stock?
There is. In fact, this week we're up, which is great news. It's been like gradually creeping up for the last couple of weeks and it's at 1.27% this week. So, this is a good move.
Wonderful. Sounds good.
Also, New Zealand is in fact down though, down 1.2%. So this is an average over the country as a whole.
Okay, sounds good. And then we're on to rent price movements. What's happening there? Mm-hmm.
So the capital cities are all performing stable. Sydney is at 12.04%, Melbourne 8.02%, and Perth is 18.47%, which brings the national average up to 12.85%. So, but this is really good for our tenants. It's giving them a lot more opportunity. There's more buyers on the market, more buyers and investors out there. So it's opening some opportunities for our renters, which is great.
And certainly for the interest rates then, I mean, maybe you can jump in there. Is any thoughts on whether interest rates you think are going to go up or not?
I think we're probably pretty settled for a little while. I don't think we're going to see the same sort of jumps that we saw sort of 10 years ago. As we see housing prices steady, which we have after the last quarter, we saw a little bit of an increase. I suspect towards the end of the year and the early start to the following year that we will see a little bit of an increase. How much will depend on
what
the growth
is. No need to panic at the moment.
Not yet.
Good stuff. And what about vacancy rates?
Overall, we are up this week. So Sydney 4.35%, Melbourne 3.8%, and Perth 5.7%.
Wonderful. All sounds good. Now, I've been talking at the home buyer shows and also travelling with Charles for the Millionaires Tour, and there's a lot of people that are always discussing about agents. What agents should I choose and what are the reasons? Obviously, you're from the marketing side of things. Mm-hmm. For people that are going with a massive chain like a Century 21 that's got a big brand, what would you say is the difference between them doing that versus doing just a local agent that's got Tom Smith on it?
Yeah. I think overall each network is obviously different, but going with a strong branded network, you often do see some great advantages. This might be from the fact that there is a national presence or sometimes even a global presence, but you often will see some consistency in terms of service and things like that. And of course, not to say that an independent won't have an exceptional experience with an independent, but I think just with the scope and size of a large network, they have the resources to really help put you front of mind. So whether, you know, it's a national television campaign or maybe even a national media PR campaign, things like that make a real difference when it comes to whether you're buying or selling your property.
And especially when you get buyers coming in that I guess are new to the market, like first home buyers, then a lot of them are pretty nervous, they're unsure. So suddenly, if they're dealing with a brand that they've seen on TV or seen plenty around, it potentially gives them more confidence.
It's just that recognition, I think, and we all, I mean, think of anything that's a big brand or a big name, you automatically know that you're going to have that consistent product, consistent service.
Yeah. And how are your agents generally finding the market at the moment? Like, is everyone generally pretty happy?
Well, I think that we're excited that there's more properties coming onto the market, so it's keeping them busy for sure.
Wonderful. Jane Wilkinson from Century 21 and Dave Hodge from Thurview. Good to see you guys.
Thanks.
And thanks for joining us at home as usual. We'll be back next week. Until then, I'm Chris Gray. Good night.
The information featured in this program is general in nature and therefore should not be relied upon. Guests appearing on the program may have commercial arrangements with some of the companies mentioned. Before making any investment, insurance or financial planning decisions, you should consult a licensed professional who can advise whether your decision is appropriate for you.